Shewer Maha, Thomas and Shaw, Toskarak, Unairan, La Martina Anderson, and Shaw of Barlaman's Naharpat, and Toskarak, Unfactus, Am Danirinia. You're very welcome to the European Parliament, where we're here under the invitation of Martina Anderson, the MEP, with a delegation of the Time for Truth campaign back home in Ireland. Martina, what is the importance and the significance of having the opportunity for campaign and legacy families to engage with the European institutions?
Well, when you consider that over 17 years ago, the British government were found guilty of breaching its Article 2, its right to life obligations in the European Court of Human Rights, it was important, I felt, during this mandate that MEPs and the different institutions understood that Britain's dirty war in Ireland had not been addressed or resolved by the British establishment. If anything, they denied the fact that collusion had taken place. We were told the collusion was an illusion, the choose to kill policy was right during the conflict, and that people like the Bloody Sunday victims and others, they said, had been involved in armed actions. They had just told lies. And then once they were exposed, they have delayed all of that, and then they're hoping that families will die off and they will get away with the role that they have played during the conflict in Ireland. So this is the sixth delegation that I have brought out here as the MEP for the North, and who are representing the family in terms of being their voice when they are not here. And it's important that MEPs from across the European Parliament get an opportunity to hear the harrowing testimonies from the families themselves. And you cannot be in a room like that but be moved by your own personal experience and trying to seek justice and truth for your loved ones. So that's why it was crucial that this is my last delegation before being kicked out here. And I must say, you know, there was a number of competing demands coming to me because it is the last delegation. But I showed in December the 5th the Ballymurphy precedent here, and I had family members over. And at the end of that film, I knew that my last delegation had to be a legacy delegation.
And Séamus Finucane, you're here representing your brother Pat and the broader Finucane family. What's the latest with your own case and your own campaign, and why is it important for you to be here today?
Well, it's important to bring our case to Europe because the British government have been intransigent and obstructive and inhibited every attempt by us to seek redress in terms of Pat's political assassination in 1989. It's his 30th anniversary next Tuesday, and we will have to suffer the trauma of revisiting that brutal night. We are currently awaiting the outcome of a Supreme Court judgment which will rule on the need for a public inquiry, which was awarded to us as a result of the Weston Park talks in 2001. And we have been in talks and negotiations and court cases with the British government since then. And they have made it very, very difficult for us to arrive at closure in terms of getting truth and justice on what happened on the night of Pat's murder. But not only just what happened, but why it happened, who procured it, who covered it up, and who continue to cover it up to this day.
Yeah, Ciarán, MacAirt, you're here representing the McGurk's family, but there's obviously a broader range of families, quite a comprehensive range of campaigns here today, Ciarán, in this delegation. How significant has the coming together under the Time for Truth banner been, and what is the importance from that campaign that MEPs should be taken away with them?
There are a number of important issues. Firstly, families who might have had a voice before now came together with people who were of like minds and had like experiences. And they found for once that they had a voice. Also, I don't think the NIO or the British state were expecting us to have such a groundswell of support, because along with the support of our political reps, the families put 7,000 people onto the streets of Belfast in February last year. And we also collected nearly 15,000 consultations for dealing with the legacy of the past. And I think the total amount was just over 17,000. So the vast, vast majority came from the Time for Truth campaign. And our objectives are very simple, and they apply across the community regardless of background or creed. And that is for the proper implementation of the Stormont House Agreement and to ensure that it's properly Article 2 compliant. The proper funding of the Police Ombudsman's Office, because it's being starved of resources, and the proper funding of the coronial inquest system, as laid out by Lord Chief Justice Declan Morgan.
And obviously one of the big campaigns that exposed the need for all of that proper resourcing and proper support has been the Loch Island campaign. Oonagh Hanlon's here, your uncle was murdered in that atrocity, and we'll have later as part of this visit the showing of No Stone Unturned, the award-winning, groundbreaking documentary. How important has that film been and that platform been for your campaign, and really why would you encourage MEPs and why is it significant for them to be there this afternoon?
Well, the documentary itself has been immeasurable, really. You know, it's documenting exactly what all the six men's families have been through, and it really is a must-see because it really is so important that no stone unturned, no stone will be unturned for every family looking for truth and justice.
Well, that's the truth. Yeah. Thanks very much, folks, and good luck with the delegation.
Thank you.
Thank you.